Hey, how's everybody doing? Ignore how I look today. I am rough, y'all. I am rough. But we're coming to you from inside the tiny house. My little cabin here. I'm sitting inside and it's awesome and I am enjoying it thoroughly. I can't stay in here yet. It's not completely dried in, but it will be soon. It will be really soon. Like I said, I can't stay in here, but I'm in here for the live stream. Hopefully my signal is good. Y'all can hear me and see me okay, and it stays good, hopefully. I have the little buddy heater sitting here close to me because it's a little cool this evening. And I have my little power station sitting over here on the floor beside me. And I have a little light bulb hanging up over the bedroom doorway here above me, or kind of above and to the side. That way, if it gets too dark in here and you can't see me, I can at least flip that light out and hopefully you'll still be able to see me. Hopefully we don't have to end early because of the lack of light. But we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. May say hey to everybody in chat. We've got Jesus is Lord, K62, Kathy Florida Girl, Kathy Williams, Peaceful Des, Diane Myers, Lori Karp, Joseph Compton, Jackie Lovestrom. We've got Rainey Moore, Glenda Bandel. Oh, I'm sorry, not Jackie, Jock. Sorry about that. My vision is really bad and I do not have my reading glasses out here with me. But we'll try to do our best. It's not quite as blurry as it is sometimes. So maybe I can see enough to at least keep with chat here. James Hall and Heather Hopper, Heartland HQ with Dinkin Tank. Annette is here, DuPont. Judy Harmon. We've got Marie Zafonte. Suzanne is here. And my chat just jumped all the way to the bottom. I'm gonna see if I can get back up to where it was. Do you hear that? The wind is blowing a little bit and it's making the little heater make noise. Can hear and see you fine, says Suzanne. Thank you. Thank you. I'm glad to know that. Rose is here, Chastain. We've got Making It Home, Lauren and Joel. Liam is here, Nancy Gibson, Ryan Kelly, Crazy John, Brian Wilkerson, Trish Keen, Peg Franklin, Bernadette is here, Itsy Bitsy Dreamstead, Donna O'Keefe. My goodness, we got 189 people in chat. 201. Oh my goodness. All right, we're over 200. I ain't gonna be able to keep up with chat, y'all. But hey to everybody. Welcome to the live chat. I'll try to catch people as their comments come up. And I will try to keep an eye on chat in between talking because, I like to interact with y'all. That's why we do a live stream, right? I also have a gift to show you that came in the mail this last week. Actually, I think it sat there for a week before I got to it. When our roads are bad, I ain't kidding, our roads are bad. Go ask White Rock Nation over there, White Rock Homestead. They came over here to help me with a project the other day before they went home. And she's like, girl, you don't want to even drive your roads. She knows I have anxiety about the roads. And she says, oh no, oh no, it's horrible. It's terrible. I said, I told you, our roads are clay. There's no gravel. It's clay and they're awful and they're very scary. And so when it rains, you don't go anywhere for at least a couple of days. And then this time of year, it just gets complete mush. And clay on clay is just sloppy and you slide everywhere and it's dangerous. So even with my little four-wheel drive, which would, maybe help me get out of the ditch, but it ain't gonna keep me from going into it. Some people say, oh, get over it. You're just being crazy. You're just being too paranoid about it or. It's not true. They are really, really bad. There are other people around here that drive on their dirt roads just fine, and their dirt roads are a lot more taken care of than mine. Mine is very, very long, and it has no gravel on probably 85% of it. So, Yeah, it's pretty bad. Anyway, I'm gonna drop down into chat. We got 257 people in here. Welcome. Hey, how you doing? And thank you for joining me. Like I said, we are live from inside of the tiny cabin today. The guys have their set up back here of tools and supplies that they're working on. If I flipped you around, which maybe I will in a little bit, there's a table saw over here and a lighter over there and boards up against the walls. And over here I've got insulation and felt paper. Back behind me there, that silver thing you see is a little scaffolding ladder. Excuse me, that one of you wonderful people sent to me. And we've been using that to get up and down off of the loft. And then they had my triangle ladder, the one with the American flag on it that y'all see all the time. It was up in the loft. So, day four is the last day that you have seen. And it actually is the last day that we have built on the cabin. A lot of things happened over the weekend, a lot of things happening this week. We've got Valentine's Day today. Some people have appointments and things that they've got scheduled into their schedules that they have to do. So we're working on it. We're going to get back to work on the cabin probably next week. And we'll just kind of go from there. But White Rock, and I can't say their name. Tara and Jason came over here the other day and they helped me with a sweet project that you actually saw started. And we got that project finished. And that video should be coming to you tomorrow afternoon. So you will get a video this week. And it does have to do with the cabin. So be looking for that. And my next thing on the cabin, after the roof is done and after the gable ends are sheathed, will be to start working on the laundry room. The laundry room is kind of the hub of my house. The water will come into there and be dispersed throughout the house. Also, the power will come into the laundry room and be dispersed in the house. So I can't really do a whole lot in here. I could set my electrical boxes. I could run the wire in here, and then just leave it there at the door of where the laundry room is going to be. So if I'm able to get to town tomorrow, then I may go pick up, electrical outlets boxes. And I have wire. I've had the wire for a while. I'll pick up outlet boxes and switches and outlets and all that good stuff. But just setting the boxes and knowing kind of where I'm going to put them, that's a big deal. But that stuff's coming up. I mean, there's a lot to do in here before I even can move in. I need the laundry room finished because I need to get water in here and I need to get power in here. Not saying that I don't think that I'm gonna come in here and spend the night once it's dried in. I probably will, but I'm not actually moving in yet. I'm gonna wait to move in, quote unquote, until there is power and water in here. Maybe even wait till there's a toilet, and maybe a sink. I don't know. We'll see. Definitely. We'll try to have the insulation in before I move in, the electrical run and the plumbing ran. So we'll just see. We'll see. I'm not sure yet. All right. Hey, Jovita. Hi, Philip Ryder. Hey, Our Mountain Home. That is Jen and Wiley. They go live right before I do. I know a bunch of you jumped over here from their channel. Sorry I missed your live, but we'll watch the replay. Oh, Our Mountain Home. Yeah, I kind of missed their live too. I got to go in for a few minutes, but I was running in between doing things and I wanted to set up out here so that y'all could kind of be in my cabin with me. And it feels amazing. It feels amazing, y'all. It's such a huge blessing. Yeah. It's such a huge blessing. Yeah, I'm looking at the sky out the the side of the gable end wall, and it's gorgeous, and it's been an absolutely beautiful day. And but just looking at my ceiling at that tongue and groove is gorgeous. It is gorgeous. It's beautiful, y'all. You just, I mean, except for being here in person, seeing it, like I've seen it on the videos too. It's a beautiful little cabin, says Drew's Lens. Yes, it is. It's gorgeous. And I couldn't be more blessed. I just couldn't. This crew, I have no words. I can't even thank them enough for what they have done for me. And they're still coming back after having been on that steep roof. They're coming back. Paul's talking to us. I was like, wait a minute, caps from Paul. And still giving it a go and coming back and doing more and doing more. And everybody's getting a big break this week. They've got projects going on, and they've got, you know, Valentine's Day to celebrate with their significant others. I don't have no significant others, so I'm just kind of sitting here. It's just been another day for me. I've been out here working, of course. They're going to finish the job, right? Says Joe Jacobson. Oh, of course they are. So Mama V, what room are you sitting in? I'm actually sitting in the living room. I'm kind of at the middle of the house here. To this side of me where that stuff is sitting, that's the bedroom. This is a wall that will be closed up right behind me. And that right there is the bathroom. Over here to my front left is the kitchen. And then over here is the living room, which I'm kind of sitting at the edge of over here. but it just feels amazing to be in here, sitting in here, doing my live stream from in here. It's amazing. It's amazing. I can't get over it. I can't get over it, y'all. All right, I'm gonna get back into chat here. Hey, Bill. How you doing up there in Alaska? Hobita says, I'm happy for you. Penny Ford says, looks great. Thank y'all. Thank you so much. I love that tongue and groove ceiling, Glenda says. Oh, it's gorgeous. It is a blue pine, and it has those blue streaks every once in a while. I have not made a decision on whether I am going to just do a clear on it or whether I'm going to stain it a light oak color. I don't really care for light wood, blonde-ish wood, but with those blue streaks going through it, it is really, really pretty. So it may just stay like it is, and I may darken the rafters to like a medium wood color, but I don't know. It's beautiful as it is. It is. It's beautiful as it is. Mama V, are you a bath soaker? Walk-in tub would be nice. I am. You know, living on the road for so long, plus my health issues, I have trouble standing and doing that. So I am putting a tub in. I'm going to put a clawfoot tub in the bathroom. One way or the other, I'm going to have a clawfoot tub in the bathroom. And it's going to be right up against that front window. Well, a little bit away from the window because there'll be a faucet there because it will have a side faucet, side drain, or a side faucet, you know, to come into the side of the tub there. So it will have a tub with a sit-down shower. So it will have a shower head, but not up on the ceiling. You know, I may in the future put a, like one of the metal rings that you hang the shower curtain from up at the top of the clawfoot tub. They do make those for the clawfoot tubs that kind of hang from the ceiling. Because there is a ceiling in the bedroom and the bathroom. there is a ceiling because there's a loft over both of those. Let me see if I can show you. Let me see if I can get this thing to move. There we go. So up here, woo, there we go. That helps. Right there are the loft joists. That is just OSB. It's actually the subfloor for the laundry room, but we put it up there so that the guys could walk on it and give them some place to be able to organize for working on the roof. So that's up there for that reason. But this will actually be a tongue and groove floor that matches the ceiling on this loft. And so there is a ceiling in the bedroom and the bathroom. In the bedroom, there'll be a ceiling fan because we have a ceiling right there to hang it from. And in the bathroom, there will be a light over by the bathtub, and there'll be two little lights by the vanity, the cabinet, seat cabinet. But yes, there will be a bathtub. Thank you so much for the memberships. We got 10 membership gifts from David Moffitt. Thank you so much. That's awesome. Welcome to the new members. hey, Atasha and Debaka and a vent fan. Yes, there'll be an exhaust in the bathroom. And then the rest of the house, of course, has the cathedral ceiling, and it's gorgeous. It only takes one cup of coffee per month to keep your gifted memberships active. That is true, David. Yeah, actually a very small cup of coffee because my lowest membership is, I think, 99 cents so a month. So, yeah, it's only a dollar. would you still be so enthusiastic if I... What? Okay, I missed something. Okay, Paul. Hey, Cheryl Guess. Just described my bathroom. Antique clawfoot tub with a shower ring. Cool. Mine's probably, I guess I missed day four, says Joe Jacobson. Yeah, you need to go watch day four. Day four. There's three videos so far, plus the live stream that we did. Video one is day one. Video two is days two and three. And video three is day four. And then the next video will just depend on the actual cabin build. There'll be other videos, but on the actual cabin build, as far as the roof is concerned, the next video will be either day five or day five and six. We'll see how it ends up going and what happens. From there. Hey, Bobby. I love clawfoot tubs, says Christy. Me too. And that's something I was just fixing to say. My clawfoot tub will probably not be an antique tub. One, because they're so cold. My only downside to having an antique clawfoot tub is they are very, very cold. And I'm not like going to have heated floors or I'm going to have heat, but my heat will be provided by my wood stove. And I got a wall between my wood stove and my bathroom. You know, I'll have the doors open to the bedroom and it's a small house. So it shouldn't be a problem keeping it warm in there, but I don't want to sit in a really cold tub. And two, I kind of need it to be a specific size. So I have found what I want. It's a acrylic clawfoot tub. It is not a cast iron one. I have found some good deals on cast iron ones on Marketplace, but most of them need restored. And I don't have time for another project right now to restore the enamel on a clawfoot tub. I don't have it in me. I have so much on my plate for this year of the cabin, just doing the cabin alone. I need to build another chicken coop. I need to expand the area, the fencing area for the animals. I want to expand that. I want to expand the size of the chicken runs. There's still a lot of projects to left to do, so I don't have time for pulling on another one with a tub. I'm probably just gonna have to buy the tub, which it is what it is. They're beautiful too. Actually, they got even more ornate feet than some of the old ones. I like the idea of an old cast iron one. I just the reality of it being so cold and the restoration it will probably need. And if the restoration wasn't needed, then it's probably going to be just as expensive as buying a newer one. So, is what it is. Hey, Cindy Brown and Biddy Boo, how's Dana doing? Debbie Druck, hey, I needed a gantry and winch just to refinish an antique tub. On all sides. Debaca, I know it's a lot of work and I'm just not up for it. I'm just not up for it. I got too many things on my plate already. Hey, Puppy the Good Troll. Cast iron tubs take forever to heat up. That's true too. That's another down. I mean, there's downsides and upsides. But I can get that look in acrylic and it won't be as heavy in the bathroom. I don't have to worry about the floor so much. There's different reasons that it would be best to go the other way. Hey, Evelyn Newman and Mike Birch, Leanne, Kathy, no, me too. That will be far lighter than a cast iron. Yes, it will be. I'm missing chats, so I was like, what? Atasha says it is easy to come across one in Arkansas, the older kind. I wondered that myself as well. It's probably easy to come across them, but they just needs a lot of work. And yeah, like I said, just don't have time. And they're very, very heavy too. Am I the only one that hates winters? Is Kathy Florida girl? No. I mean, I'm not in love with winter, but I'm not, clawfoot tubs are really, oops, why does it always jump? Really to move, hard, probably hard to move. Yeah. I think, just going acrylic, it will be so much easier. And there's such a big variety of sizes too. To put when, where I want it, how I want it in the bathroom. Because I'm only working with a 7x8 space here, which is even smaller once you put the walls on, you got the walls. So, yeah, there's not a whole lot of room in there. But that's the way I wanted it. That's good. Cool old house, but it's in town. It's a different conversation. Hello from El Paso, Texas. Well, welcome, Freedom One. Tamara. Tamaro Ozuna. Sorry if I butchered that. I didn't mean to, but I'm, yeah, trying. Same, Kathy, hit me. 300-year-old home. We are the only house with two hitching posts still. Oh, how cool. Just gonna bank on I can find one marketplace when I get there. Yeah. They are on marketplace. The thing is, if you get one that's already restored, you're gonna save no money. You're gonna pay the same price. What kind of floors are you going to put down? Says Kathy Worth. I am going to put wood floors down. Don't know exactly what that's going to look like yet. More than likely, tongue and groove, just like the ceiling. I don't know if I'll go with the blue pine again or if I'll just go with a regular pine because I am going to stain the floors and protect them. And I know that I'm going to stain them. They're not going to be left. They're not just going to be sealed. They're going to be stained and sealed. So the bathroom and the laundry room will have a different floor. And I've not completely made up my mind yet. I'm kind of back and forth on, I did find a guy on Marketplace that has, that's in the area, not too far away, down by Drew and them. And he has different kinds of stone flooring, which I think would look gorgeous in there. I would love, love, love to do brick flooring, but those thin bricks to use for flooring are super expensive. It would cost me like $600 or more just for the bathroom. That's not happening. I think I can do it for about $200 if I go with the stone. And then the other option is using in-cuts of wood of like 2x6s or, you know, 4x4s or 6x6s or whatever, and making a floor out of that. Have heard that's a lot of work, a lot of different steps, but it may just look gorgeous enough to be worth it. So you just have to stay tuned for what I end up doing with the bathroom floor and with the laundry floor. Not absolutely sure yet. Haven't made my mind up. So if you have other suggestions, throw them at me. We got over 500 people in here, 519. Welcome to chat, y'all. So yeah, that's what's up with the floors. And supports in the foundation. Yeah. Wade says, I saw thinking about clawfoot tub in one bathroom. I have, but now I think just regular cast iron tub would be fine. Tile the walls and everything. Yeah. Yeah. I've just, you know, this is my dream house. It really is. I know it's a tiny home, but that's what I wanted. So, this is my dream house and it's getting treated like a dream house. So if I have to wait on some things to be able to have what I ultimately want in here, or if I have to do a cheap alternative option in the meantime while I save up for what I really want in here, then that's what I'll do. Because I'm pretty daggone determined on how I want this to look. I have a vision, and that vision's taking place in here, y'all. I can already about picture it in my head, you know, the big wood stove over there and my kitchen over here. Yeah, it's amazing. Chase your dream, says Random Adventures 2.0. Yep, chase your dream. Never, never give up on your dreams. Stick with your dreams. That's right. Do yourself a favor and put a walk-in shower. And there's no room for a walk-in shower, says Nurse D. And a hot tub outside. Oh, a walk-in shower and hot tub outside. Now, that's a possibility. That's a possibility. Definitely going to be a hot tub outside. And I believe it could end up being in a funky place. Yeah, I'm thinking of maybe putting it on my patio as like a built-in type of, you know, hot tub. So we'll just have to see how that comes along. That's going to be okay. There will most likely be a outside restroom and walk-in shower outside on the property. Not sure exactly where yet, not sure exactly when yet, but that is a thing and it is happening. hey, Rebecca Touched by Yarn. Karen Worth, thanks for the super chat. Oops, I didn't miss a super chat. There it is. To help with the floors, donation from my Christmas boss. Aw, thank you so much, Karen Worth. That's awesome. That is awesome. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I sure appreciate that. Love the ceiling. Y'all want to see the ceiling real quick? Yeah, I got to show you because it's gorgeous. All right, you're going to leave me for a second. You're going up. There you go. You're going. You're going. There's the loft. And there's the ceiling. Oh, that's as far as it'll let me go. Maybe if I turn you some. I don't know how to do this. There. If I turn you some, maybe you can see more. There you go. There's the ceiling, y'all. That's pretty cool, huh? It's almost done. Let me get you turned back around here so I can put you back down. I don't want to move you too fast. Because, hello. Yeah, there we go. Let me see if I get this thing tightened back up. Uh-oh, it doesn't want to tighten back up. Come on. Tighten back up. There it goes. All right, now it's tightened back up. yeah, the ceiling is gorgeous. It's way higher than it looks. Trust me, it is. It is. Here's some perspective for you. The cabin itself, I'm not talking about under the cabin, the height off of the ground. I'm talking about the cabin walls are 9 foot. From the top of the cabin walls at 9 foot, the peak of this roof is another 10 foot, 1 inch. The peak, the ceiling is taller than the cabin itself. can technology can be difficult? It sure can. It's not 20 foot, Drew. It is 19 foot, 1 inch from the floor to the peak of the ceiling. 12-12 pitch. It's up there, y'all. Hey, Southwest Living with Val. Oh, goodness. Southern Blessed says your cabin is beautiful. It is. It's gorgeous. It is just gorgeous. I will totally agree. I love it. Hey, Rainy Ridge. Clear coat definitely is the way I would personally choose to go. Yeah, I'm really thinking of that because of that pretty blue, and it will probably bring the blue out even more. But because of that pretty blue in the blue pine, I'm thinking it will just make it look that much more grand, I guess. I've always dreamed of having a cathedral ceiling my whole life, since I was a little girl. I dreamed of having a cathedral ceiling, and I have one. I have one, y'all. Jeez. Yes. Thank you, Wayne. Happy Valentine's Day to all the ladies. Gotta go be a cab driver, says Cindy Brown. All right, honey. Take it easy. Have a good evening. Thank you, Jacques, for all the... It's... Oh, man. Yeah, the ceiling is gorgeous. And, I mean, I'm just in awe. Every time I walk out of the camper, I'm just... Jaw drops. It's like, I just cannot believe it. I cannot believe it's here, that's sitting here, that, just over a year from the time I dug the first footers to now. Those footers went in the ground on January 8th last year. And here we are, mid-February, and we got a roof going on. And it's fixing to be dried in. Unbelievable. Hey, O'Rourke's Littlefield, how y'all doing over there? Dreams do come true, says Wayne. You got that right. Shingle or metal, says Random Adventures 2.0. Metal. It's metal. I have not revealed the color yet. You will see that most likely on the next cabin build video. Because that's what we'll be doing. We'll be finishing up those last couple of boards that they left up there to be able to access the roof. And getting furnace strips on and starting the metal. Hey, Dawn Ray B, how are you doing? Really amazing to see the house now. It's beautiful. I know, Bonnie. I mean, it's come so far so quick. How will you insulate the roof, says Biddy Boo Brown. Dana, I actually have the insulation on the roof now. It is a sandwiched roof. The roof is cathedral ceiling. It's sandwiched with a double reflectix insulation, a double bubble. So we have the 30-pound felt and then the insulation and then the... furring strips will go on top of that, and then the metal. And the roofing guys at the place where I purchased the roof. That was their suggestion for cathedral ceiling as far as my sandwich layers. And yeah. Don't be a bum, hit that thumb. Yep. Hey, Carla Simons. Yep, 12-12 was great for winter snow. Yeah, 12-12 was great for the snow, the rain, everything. I got hit in the head by raindrops for the first time coming out of my cabin the other day. I'm not used to having a roof on there, and it was just a pouring down rain. And, you know, usually you walk outside and you get, you know, the raindrops all around you, right? No. I walked out, and it was like, because I don't have a gutters or anything up there right now. And I got drenched. Yeah, just something else that just not used to. And eventually that won't happen because there'll be another roof for the porch there. I may actually have to do a gutter before that because I tell you what, just a couple of days that we have had rain since the roof has been on, it's digging a little trench along the front of my house. And I don't like that. Hey, Jay Marie. Hi, Sheila. How are you doing? And Mark. What kind of siding are you planning on using? That's another thing I haven't totally decided on. I was actually talking to Gumby over at Junk to Gems today. And we discussed that a little bit. We discussed the plumbing and the electrical and the a few things. But we also discussed what I was going to site it with and when I'm going to site it. He suggested sooner the better. I mean, I agree, but I just don't know when it's going to happen. My options are, I would love to do board and batten. Board and batten is beautiful, especially when it's weathered. I think it's gorgeous, and I would like to do board and batten, but it's pretty expensive. Would really... you know, isn't as bad as it was, but isn't as good as it was either. So I don't know. I'm going to price different options. Board and batten is one option. And it's my favorite. I also have the option of doing like what I did on the shed. If y'all watch the shed videos of me building the little pole barn shed, I used end cut slabs on there. What I would do different if I use them on the cabin is I would make sure that they're all peeled, which I didn't on the shed. I would also cut down, rip the sides, both sides of the slab to make it have a straight edge so that the boards fit together better. I would have to chink in between them, a small chinking of some sort between them. But it's a very inexpensive option. It's very labor intensive because I have to go pick out all the boards from the junk that the sawmill has. Or I could do the same thing with cedar instead of pine, and the cedar bundles are already bundled up. And it's not super expensive either, but same thing, labor intensive because you got to cut every board on both sides and you got to strip every board. But, you know, I don't know. So those are options. And then the other option that I didn't know of that Gumby told me was there is a cement hardy board that's like a cement fiber board that is siding, and it comes in 4x8 sheets, and you could put that up and use battens on it and make it look like board and batten, but it would be concrete, so it would last for a long time and be very, very protective. But it's like $50 a sheet, so that get pretty expensive. So I don't know, I'm tossing around all the ideas. We'll see in the future. Right now I got a lot of things to consider. What type of insulation in the walls? R13 roll insulation fiberglass. will be in the walls. And if I run the plumbing interior instead of underneath, if I run it interior, then I will also put foam board insulation, the polyiso stuff, behind the plumbing in the bottom half of the wall. You know, you can see how I've got, let me see right there. Those blocks in the middle, fire blocks. So the bottom half of the wall would also have the polyiso insulation against on my exterior walls. And that way that'll protect my pipes. Otherwise, I'll run the pipes underneath the cabin in the floor joists, and then they'll be heat taped, or, you know, something to protect them down there. So, yep. White Rock. Hey, Tara and Jason. Possum Run, Homestead, that cement board don't last. Trust me, we used it. Sucks up water, then it crumbles. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's good to know. good. I think that is what Good Simple Living uses, Don Raby. Okay. We used on the well house, and we added battens, then painted it, says White Rock. Okay, cool. Cedar Shake shingle is awesome, but labor intensive. Yep, that's another one, but it's very labor intensive, and it's expensive too. Yeah. Have you found anything good on your little treasure hunt today, Tara and Jason? I did my second house with board and batten with metal roof. I love the look. Me too, Nurse Day. It's gorgeous. Drew's Lens is asking if White Rock's back home. Yeah, they got home. Rochelle, thanks for the super chat. Rochelle Armitage, here to help you along, Mama V. Awesome. Thank you so much for the $20 super chat. You're awesome. All you wonderful people. You're just so awesome. Thank you so much. Yes, that'll very much help with the flooring in the bathroom. And yeah, because I think that's kind of my next thing is to get flooring down in here. I have to do some replacements. We'll talk. I have something I have to replace in here. I have a couple pieces of my floor that got too damaged by the water. And it's going to be best if I go ahead and replace those. So I'm going to have to pull, a couple of my 3/4 inch out and replace, it's along the back wall where they just got way too damaged. They would probably be okay for a while, but why would I do that? In 5 years, I would have problems, and then I would have cabinets and a refrigerator and a sink and, you know, all kinds of things on top of them to deal with. Do it now. So I'm going to do that now. I'm not afraid to say that there was mistakes, because there was. I put all this subfloor down, and I believe it was like November. And so it sat for a long time uncovered. I tried to protect it the best I could. The advice I got from, someone that I really trust and who has many, 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 many years of experience was to spray it with boiled linseed oil. So I did that, and it didn't work. Unfortunately, it was just out too long. So, you know, you do what you can do. So now I'll be doing a little bit of repair work, fixing the mistakes that I have made. And, you know, everybody makes them. Don't be afraid to say you made mistakes. I'm not perfect. I'm definitely not a carpenter. I'm definitely not a builder. I'm just an old lady on YouTube, you know, living my dream. You know, I am here because this is my dream, and I'm just doing the best I can with what I have and what knowledge that I can scrounge up. Oh my goodness, we got 599 people in chat. Wow, y'all are amazing. Hey, Mary Murphy. Oh, without further ado, here, let me show you this before we, you know, we're getting close to being done with our live stream. And we got a package in the mail. It actually sat up there for a week at the post office because I couldn't get to town. And so let me show you what we got here. It is a sign. And it is super cute, and it is definitely me. I'm going to take it out of this packaging because you can't even see the whole thing with it in the packaging. So I'm going to try to take it out of the package here. Laura says, you're amazing. Thank you. Let's see. Come on. Come out of there. He doesn't want to cooperate. All right. Here we go. Here it is, y'all. Look at this. Isn't that cute? Isn't that cute? Da-da-da-da-da. That is so cute. It says, once upon a time, there was a girl who really loved moose. That was me. The end. Isn't that cute? I hang that up somewhere out here in the cabin. That is adorable. Thank you. Thank you for the person who sent this to me. I don't know if you want your name mentioned, but thank you. You know who you are. All right. Let me sit that down there. And Southwest Living. Oh, it just jumped. Come on. Why do you jump that way? You ain't old, Mama V. If you're old, that means I'm old because I'm older than you, James. Yep, super cute. 404 thumbs up. Yeah, we got 625 people in chat. That's awesome, y'all. I'm here but driving, says Cuddly Texan. Well, thank you for being here. Only 162 thumbs up. You might want to refresh, Kevin. How many of you, 599, have hit the thumbs up yet, says Bill. Thanks for the reminder. It's never cheap. I still can't find that message I was trying to read. We also had a new member, and it jumped out of the way, too. And so I have no idea who it was, because it just blew it. I mean, my chat's just a-moving like crazy. You've done great, says Bitty Boo. Thank you. Hey, Troy Sutton. Except for from the weather, tarp. Yeah. There is a tarp on it now. There is a tarp. It's, it might be a little holy, but there is a tarp up there, and it's helping protect it now. I just didn't, at the time, I didn't have a big enough tarp to cover the whole thing once I got the walls up, because it would have had to cover all the way to even think about protecting the floor. And I should have done it. I should have just found a way to make that happen, but I can't go back and change that now. I lost that chat that I was trying to get to. It's going. Hey, back to good. Hey, dear dime. And you have to get storage set up. Yeah. I always hit the thumbs up, said Trish. Cool. Yeah. That always helps to hit that thumbs up. Don't be able to hit that thumbs. Awesome. Hey, Terry Three, how are you doing? Yes, happy Valentine's Day, everyone. Also, I wanted to say to everyone, Jan and Kevin over at Simply Jan Homestead. Kevin is sick, and I'm not sure exactly what is going on to share with you. I don't want to share. So, anyway, but just send some prayers up for him, please. He's having a really rough time of it. So please send some prayers his way. Love your sign. Yep, it's cute. I won't. Oh, you're talking about moving. Yeah, it's a cute little sign. All right, well, it's jumping down to the bottom. Hey, great. It's jumping down to the bottom, so it's not going to let me see that I was trying to find that chat that I saw. I know how to tarp with the walls up. Wish I could have helped you. Yeah. You know, you just live and learn, especially when you don't know. You just do the best you can do. And I did the best I could do. And most of the subfloor is fine, and it made it. But there are a couple of pieces that didn't. And it's basically that back row. Didn't do well. So I will be cutting that out. And actually, it's kind of a blessing, because if I cut that out, then I have access for if I decide to put my plumbing underneath there and my plumbing for my discharge pipes from the sink and all that, I can access them much easier because the back is kind of low. It's 14 inches and I'm too big of a girl to fit underneath there. So I don't even know if DD5, if Mike could get underneath there and actually have the room to work, you know, with getting the plumbing up. So, I mean, maybe it's a blessing in disguise that we can go underneath there with that open. Do that external plumbing that needs to be under there and then close it back up. So, it'd be all right. thank you for prayers for the boss, for Kevin. I appreciate that. But yeah, I got a message from Jan earlier saying she wouldn't be here in the live stream, that she's taking care of him, and wanted y'all to keep him in your thoughts and prayers. Let's see. Thumbs up. Well, thank you. Thumbs up. Something else a little side project I'm working on. Because it's going to be a little while, because I have to build the laundry room first, and get, you know, water over here. But as soon as that laundry room is in and walls are up on it, I'm going to put my water heater that Joseph gave me. I'm going to put that in there and we're going to have a makeshift outdoor shower. So that's going to be cool. That's coming up too. I want to get that done, and it's getting warm enough now where I can do an outside shower instead of having to go to the campground. And yeah. That'll be cool. And just a couple other little projects that I'm working on too. Everybody, oh, she's saying bye. And David Moffat, for those interested, I'm now drop shipping mugs and t-shirts. Full color. Awesome. Don Ray B, oh my goodness, girl. Don Ray B has $75 super chat. Because I was going to send you a Lowe's card back when you don't have transportation. So I'm sending it this way now for your dreams. Aw, thank you so much. Yeah, I probably got enough now for these super chats to be able to get that stone if that's what I want to do or be able to do something and have a flooring in my laundry room. That's awesome, y'all. Y'all are amazing. Wow. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. My vote is the walls with the plumbing. Won't freeze. All right, y'all, we are getting close to time. We really are. Mary Murphy, White Rock, glad you guys made it home safe. Yes, they were such a blessing, y'all. I tell you what, they sure were. But it is time. We made it without the sun going completely down. You can still see me, so we're going to get going. I am going to go ahead and head in. Get all this stuff moved out of my way and turn my little heater off. And then we'll see you on the next one. Hopefully, we'll have a video for you tomorrow. I'm going to work on that tonight, finishing that video up for you. Get that uploaded tomorrow. And then I'm going to go to town and try to get some stuff taken care of. And then next week, We should be back to work on the cabin again. Just depending on everybody's schedule. We'll see what happens. We'll see what get done between now and then, y'all. We got 5 minutes left before Three Mississippi goes live because it's family night, y'all. So we've got our mountain home starts at 4 o'clock. We got right here with Possum Run Homestead with Mama V. We're right here at 5 o'clock. At 6 o'clock, we jump over to see Three Mississippi with Mel, with Sid and Mike and Frankie. And then SLR goes live at 7, and Simple Life Reclaimed. At 8 o'clock is MT Homestead. 9 o'clock is Brian with the Vineyard Farmhouse. And 10 o'clock is Old Man King Homestead with Peter. So it's a fun filled packed night. Hey, Shirley and Grady. It's a packed night on Wednesdays with wonderful live streams. Nobody boo, I can ask him. good job. Happy Valentine's says road trips, life, and redo. Well, thank you. Thank you. Yeah, everybody have a great week, great weekend. It's gonna be awesome. I still got lots to do this week. We've got some beautiful weather. I think we're supposed to have some rain on Friday. But I got little things that I can be doing in here. I swept all day today. I swept, I vacuumed. Like I'm already sweeping and vacuuming my new house. But I swept and I vacuumed in here, and I did a little bit of spray foam. And if you stayed this long, you might as well know what I did. I did some spray foam and did a lot of just cleaning up and making the place a little easier to get around in. Got all the trash off the floor, the pine needles and dirt is what I mean by trash, not trash trash. So yep, got all that stuff done. And all right, yeah, I think I'm gonna end it just a tad bit early. We're gonna head out. I'm gonna make my way over to the camper, make me some supper, and we'll see you over at Three Mississippi's. Love y'all. Have a great evening. God bless.